Hello friends, welcome to this video. So in yesterday's video we discussed matrices and in today's video we will be discussing determinants. Okay. So determinants, first of all, what is the basic idea for determinant? So see, determinant is a number we associate with a square matrix. It's only possible for a square matrix. Suppose I have a square matrix A, B, C, D. Then suppose this matrix is A, then determinant of A is written as like this. It's not modulus. Okay, it's not modulus. It's the determinant of A. Or you can also write it like det A. So this is written as A into D minus B into C. So AD minus BC. So like this we can find the determinant of a 2 by 2 square matrix. So AD minus BC will definitely be a number. Suppose this was 1, 2, 3, 4, then this would have been that. You can calculate that. So suppose you get a number n. So this n, this is a number we associate with this 2D, sorry, this 2 by 2 matrix. So that particular number, for every matrix there is a unique number, this number. But so that number is called this your determinant. That number is called determinant. And determinant is only possible for square matrices. Now see, it's not possible to say what the matrix was based on this number. Like if you know this number, then you cannot guess the matrix, because the same result you can get from many different numbers, right? But yeah, that's it. So yeah. So suppose, for example, you have a matrix 2, 4, minus 1, 2, 2, 4, minus 1, 2, and you have to find the determinant. So this will be 2 into 2 minus minus 1 into 4, that is 4 minus, this is minus 1 into 4 is minus 4, that is 4 plus 4, that is 8. So the determinant will be 8. Next is, you see, for a 3D matrix, I'm extremely sorry for this. I'm confusing these 2x2 and 3x3 matrices as 2D and 3D for some reason, I don't know why. Anyway, never mind. So for a 3D matrix, suppose we have A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. So for these kind of matrices, how can we find the determinant? First of all, you will consider, so actually let's write it in a better way. So let's write it in a better way. Suppose A11, so as we discussed in yesterday's video, this 11 means the first one represents a row number. So this is the first row, that means this will be A1. Then this will be 2 because this is the second column. This will be 3 because this is the third column. Similarly, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Okay, fine. So this is basically of the form AIJ. So for A11, I is 1, J is also 1. For A12, I is 1, but J is 2. So I think you get the idea. That's it. So first of all, you have to suppose consider this row. So if you want to find the determinant using this row, what you have to do is very simply minus 1 to the power I plus J, AIJ. First of all, you consider this element, then is this element. So for this element, minus 1 to the power I plus J, I is also 1, J is also 1. So minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1, AIJ is A11. Now, so we consider this element, right? Now, this element, the corresponding row is this, corresponding column is this. So you just forget this row and column. Now you have a 2x2 matrix left to you. Now you find a determinant of this matrix in a usual way and multiply it with this. Like you multiply like this. A22 into A33 minus A23 into A32. Okay? So I think you get it. Next is, now this is minus 1 raised to the power 1 plus 1 is 2. So minus 1 square is just plus 1. So this will just be A11 into this. I hope you get it. Next we have plus minus 1 raised to the power, this element you have to consider. Raised to the power 1 plus 2. Now 1 plus 2 is 3, that's an odd number. So this is minus 1 to the power 3 is minus 1. So this will be minus AIJ, so that's A12. Now for A12, you just forget this column and this row. So we have these four elements. So it will be like this. A21, I think this is visible to you, right? Yeah. A21, A33, minus A23, A31. Okay? I hope that's it. That's about the second. Now the last will be C. Plus minus 1 raised to the power of A13. Now A1 plus 3 is 4, that's even number, so this will just be plus 1. Then A13. Then we have, forget this column and this row, then we have A21, A32, minus A22, A31. So this is how we can find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix. Now I know this is a bit long process. I mean it's a bit amazing, tedious and everything, but it's actually like very simple. It's actually like there are some properties. Okay, so when the determinant will be given to you, you can apply these properties to make the task easier. So we will be discussing the properties of determinants shortly. So let's look at a very simple example. Suppose 1, 2, 4, minus 1, 3, 0, 4, 1, 0. So this determinant we have to find out. Now I showed you the example, we considered this row. First this element, then this element, then this element, then this. Like we considered these elements, right? But we can also do it like this. We can consider this element and this element. So when I consider this element, just forget this and this, do with this. When you consider this element, forget this and this, do with this. And for this, you just forget this and this, do with this. So we can do it column wise also. That is not a problem. Okay. So our determinant is 1 to 4 minus 1, 3, 0, 4, 1, 0. 1 to 4 minus 1, 3, 0, 4, 1, 0. So see, now in this case, we will actually do it like this because that will be easier. Why? Because see, we have a 0 here and we have a 0 here. So 0 multiplied by whatever, it will be 0. And again, 0 multiplied by this and this, that will again be 0. So we only need to consider this case. So 4, now this is what? A 1 1, A 2 1, A 3 1. So 3 plus 1 is 4. That means it is an even number. So minus 1 raised by 4, that is just plus 1. So we don't need to write this. So just 4 plus 4. Then you forget this and this. So then we have minus 1 into 1, that is minus 1. And then we have minus 4 into 12, that is minus 4 into 30. So minus 52. So that is the answer. Next we have to discuss the properties of determinants. Give me 1 second. These pens are not working. Right. So value of determinant remains unchanged if rows and columns are interchanged. That means simply A is A transpose, the determinant of A transpose. So in the previous video of matrices we discussed what is transpose. For instance, if we have A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, then the transpose is A suppose, then A transpose will be A transpose, that is A dash. This will be turn the columns into rows. So A, D, G, B, E, H, C, F, I. Very simple idea. Now if you do this, now if you try to find out the determinant, then the determinant of A will be equal to the determinant of A transpose. That means if the rows and columns are interchanged, the value of determinant will not be affected. The value of determinant remains unchanged. That's the first property. Determinant A is equal to determinant A transpose. Next is if two rows or columns are interchanged, sign of the determinant changes. Like if we have, suppose, the determinant of A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I hope this is legible. Yeah. Okay. So, I mean, this is actually, at least this is you can make out. I know my handwriting is not good, but anyway. These pens are not actually working properly and I don't have ink right now. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, this is the determinant of this. Now if I interchange two rows and columns, suppose A, B, C and D, E, F and G, H, I interchange. Like if I write G, H, I here and D, E, F here. Then the value of this determinant will be negative the value of this determinant. If I just interchange two rows, or we could have done column also. Like we can write B, E, H here and A, B, G here and C, F, I as usual. In that case also the value of the determinant will be negative the value of the original determinant. The sign of the determinant will change, nothing else. Next is if any two rows or columns are identical, then the value of the determinant has to be 0. Now this is from this this property itself, the third property is obvious. Because you see, suppose we have a determinant, like this, let's give you a very simple example. So let's suppose we have a determinant 1 1 1 0 3 2 1 1 1. Now this is the determinant, suppose A. Now if I interchange this 0, this 1 1 1 and 1 1, suppose I'm interchanging these two, I can do that, right? But in that case also you see I'm getting the same thing because these two are identical. So then also I'm getting 1 1 1 0 3 2 1 1 1. No difference. So this determinant, let's say A, but we know from the previous property that this has to be minus A because we have interchanged. That means we get the conclusion that A should be equal to minus A. Now this is not possible for any number other than 0. That means in this case the determinant must be 0. The determinant of A must be 0. Or actually we are saying that this determinant we are defining it to be A, or we can write like this. So the determinant of A has to be 0 in this case. If any two rows or columns are identical, the determinant of A has to be 0. The determinant has to be 0. Yeah, this is fine, better. So suppose if each element of a row or column of a determinant is multiplied by k, then the determinant gets multiplied by k. Suppose I have the determinant a, b, c, d, e, f, g, h, I. Suppose I multiply this k, this first row with k, only the first row, k, a, k, b, k, c, d, e, f, g, h, I. These things are not touched. So then this will be your, basically you can take the k common in the sense, you can take the k out of the determinant, you can multiply the k with this thing a, b, c, d. Suppose this is delta 1, d, e, f, g, h, I. So this thing, you see, this is just delta, so this is k delta. So delta 1 is k delta. That means if you multiply any one row or column with the constant k, the determinant will also get multiplied by k. Now a simple example, you see, suppose 102, 18, 36, 1, 3, 4, 17, 3, 6. Now see, 102 is, if you calculate it, this is 17 into 6. Similarly, 18 is 3 into 6. And 36 is 6 into 6. So, this 6 we can take common. So, 6 here and we can just drop this 6. But then we get 7, 3, 6 here and 17, 3, 6 here and 17, 3, 6 here. So, if two rows are identical, that means the value of the determinant is 0. So we can easily calculate that, we can easily say that the value of the determinant is 0 even without trying to calculate. You can check it out, just to verify it. Next is that you can split, suppose if I have in one row or column, if I have suppose A1 plus lambda 1, A2 plus lambda 2 like that, then I can split it and write it like this, I am showing you. Suppose I have like this, A1 plus lambda 1, A2 plus lambda 2, A3 plus lambda 3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. The determinant of this. Now this can be written as, simply A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Plus, this is plus, right? So plus lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So we sort of just split them. So this property can also be applied. Let for a simple example to consider this matrix here, this determinant here. A, B, C, A plus 2X, B plus 2Y, C plus 2Z, X, Y, Z. So you have to show that the value of this determinant is equal to 0. Now how can we show that? See, understand this very nicely. So suppose if we do like this, suppose this is, if I do, first of all, you see A, B, C, X, Y, Z, nothing is there which we can take common. This is the first thing which should come in our mind. We cannot take any common. But what we can do is that we can write it like this. A, B, C, A, B, C, X, Y, Z, plus A, B, C, 2X, 2Y, 2Z, and X, Y, Z. Now from here we can take the 2 common and x, y, z. Now in this case also you see x, y, z identical rows, that means this value is 0. And in this case also you see a, b, c identical rows, so this value is 0. That means the total value must be 0. Okay? Next is the last property. The determinant remains unchanged under operations like, so if you have operations, elementary operations we did in the previous class of matrices, like how to find the inverse of a matrix and those things. So suppose if you have the operation that the row I if you replace with ri plus k rj, or column, suppose ci if you replace with ci plus k cj. So if I am applying these kind of operations, determinant not changed. On applying this kind of operation, the value of the determinant remains unchanged. The determinant will not be affected. Now, I can show you a very simple proof of this here. Suppose I have Actually, this is we should be obvious from the previous properties which we discussed. Suppose A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Suppose this I have. Suppose this is your delta. Okay. Next is delta 1. Suppose I am considering A1 plus K C1. Just this operation. Ri plus K Rj. So actually, so here I am applying the operation R1 equals R1 plus K R3. This operation I am applying. Okay, nothing else. So this then A2 plus K C2 and A3 plus K C3. And this is, these all are as usual B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So now you see this, we can split it and write A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3 plus KC1, KC2, KC3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So now this K will come outside. And then C1, C2, C3, C1, C2, C3 come out, so this value will be 0. So this entire thing will be 0. So we will only have this thing left. Now this is the original delta. So delta equals delta 1. So see the value of the derivative did not change even if we applied this operation. So this is the last property. So using these properties, like you can solve a whole lot of questions. Now, let's consider a few questions, like for instance, suppose you have to evaluate this determinant using properties. Okay, 1, 1, 1, A, B, C, B, C, C, A, A, B. B, C, C, A, A, B. So first of all, you see, like no two rows are similar, no two columns are similar, nothing common you can take out. So what to do? In such cases, what to do? Obviously, you have to apply some operations. So operations means you see, if you apply, so this is not exactly trial and error. You have to understand, you have to get the intuition that what operation I should apply in this case. It's not like I'm doing trial and error. Okay. Suppose R2 equals R2 minus R1 if I replace. R2 with R2 minus R1. Okay. R2 with R2 minus R1. So that means 1ABC. R2 is this R2. So R2 1 minus 1. That is, this will become 0. B minus A, this will become B minus A. C, this is CA minus BC. That means C common A minus B, or we can write minus C B minus A. So minus C B minus A. And this is 0. Now 0 can be written as 0 into anything. 0 into B minus A we can write. Now you see we can take B minus A common from this, from the second row. Like we can take B minus A common. It's 1 into B minus A, and this is minus A into B minus A. We can do that, right? And similarly, R3 also if we do simultaneously, R3 equals R3 minus R1, if we do. And then you see 1 minus 1, this will again be 0. C minus A, this will be C minus A. So 1 into C minus A, 0 into C minus A. And this is AB minus BC. So AB minus BC is B common A minus C or minus B C minus A. So now things are not more simple. So we can just take out B minus A into C minus A. I'm just doing it in one step. So 1 A B C 0 1 minus C 0 1 minus B. So now you can just find a determinant. Now there is no more properties which you can apply. So just do it along this row because this was 0, so this will just go out. So we have only 1 into minus B minus or minus A is minus B plus C. That is, the our answer will be what? These two are there, so B minus A, C minus A into C minus B. So this will be our answer. Okay. Next is one more example we will do before moving on to the next topic, that's area of triangle. So this example you see is basically a very simple example. Suppose we have this determinant given to 1 plus A square minus B square. 2AB minus 2B. 2AB minus 2B. 2AB 1 minus A square plus B square 2A. 2B minus 2A 1 minus A square minus B square. Suppose this matrix is given to you. Now what to do? You see, first of all, your target will be C. First of all, you have to determine whether I will be doing it row-wise or column-wise. So, row-wise, you cannot bear much fruit. If you do it column-wise, you see, suppose this operation is considering C1 is C1 minus BC3. C1 is C1 minus BC3. Now, why am I doing this? Because this is C1. So, this minus, if I do BC3, so 1, actually, why am I doing this? I need to make this as at least one of the elements, I need to make it a 0. This should be my target. So 2AB I have to make it a 0. Now if I multiply a B here and just subtract it, then what will be the case? Oh, okay. One second. This is minus 2A, right? So minus 2AB. So B into C3. If I do minus, then this will become plus. So let's do plus. C1 plus BC3. Then you see what will be in here, what will you get? 1 plus a square minus b square plus 2b square. 1b is multiplied, right? So minus b square plus 2b square is plus b square. Next this will be 0. And next this will be minus 2b c1 plus 1 minus a square minus b square. Minus 2b, minus 2b plus, this is b into 1 minus a square minus b square, because we are multiplying this b with c3. So minus 2b plus b minus a square b minus b cube. So see, if I take the b common, what will I get? If I take the b common, then I will get, so first of all, minus 2 plus 1 is minus b. So minus b cube minus a square b minus b. So if I take minus b common, I get b square plus a square plus 1. So again I am getting, you see, minus b into b square plus a square plus 1. So minus b into a square plus b square plus 1. Okay. Now see, this we have a 1 into 1 plus a square plus b square, and also 1 plus a square plus b square, and this is 0. So 0 can be written as 0 into 1 plus a square plus b square. Now we can take 1 plus a square plus b square common from this, and we can take it outside, and these things will be simplified inside. Now if we do the same thing, C2 equals C2 plus AC3. Why we are doing this? C2 equals C2 plus AC3. Now why we are doing this thing? Because this is C2. So this is C2, and so we need to make it a 0, right? So at least one thing, it would be better if we can make it a 0. So C2 is C2, so that is 2AB plus AC3 plus 2AB. Wait, then that will be 4AB. Then it should be minus. Of course, minus. So C2 plus C2 minus AC3. Then this will become 0. C2 equals C2 minus AC3. Then this will become 1 minus A square plus B square minus minus plus 2A square. So that is 1 plus a square plus b square again, and this case will be 2a minus a plus a cube, then again we have a minus minus, so plus ab square. So 2a minus a is just a. So if I take the a common, 1 plus a square plus b square. So again I will have, so 1 plus a square plus b square, 2 times it will come out. So square, so this will be 1, this will be 0, and this will be minus b, and this will be 0, this will be 1 plus a square plus b square into 1, so this will be 1, and this will be a, and this will be 2b minus 2a, 1 minus a square minus b square. So now you can find out the value of the determinant now. Okay. So next is the area of a triangle. So this formula actually we have been doing for quite a few years, but here is the determinant definition of the area. So the basic one line, so previously you were asked to memorize the formula, but here you don't need to do that. Here basically, suppose the vertices of triangle are given by x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. Then the area of a triangle is given by half into determinant of x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3 and 1 here, 1, 1, 1. So it's a 3 by 3 matrix.
So this is, if you can find this and then half, then that will give you an area of the triangle. So the equation is, I am not showing here.
And so you can just check it out, like you can, for example, if you are asked to prove that this area, suppose a triangle is, suppose three points are collinear, suppose these three points are collinear, they lie on the same line. That means the triangle forms, suppose this is a triangle, so if I bring this point down like this, then I will get a line, then the area of the triangle will reduce to zero. So if three points are collinear, then the area of the triangle is zero. So that means if it's, if you are asked to show that, suppose if you are given the vertices, suppose this question is C. A comma B plus C, B is B comma C plus A, and C is C comma A plus B. Suppose you have to show that these points are collinear point. That means you have to show that the area of the triangle is zero. That means half A B plus C one, B C plus A one, C A plus B one. So you have to show that this is equal to zero. You have to show that. Okay, it's not given. So what can you do? See, suppose you do C1 is C1 plus C2. While I think C1 plus C2, then suppose this is C1. So this will become A plus B. This will become, wait a second. We are doing the column operations here. Because see, we need to, see here A is present and the other two are present here, B and C. Here B is present, the other two are present here. Here C is present, the other two are present here. So this column, if I add with this column, then I will get A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C. And this will be usual B plus C, C plus A, A plus B. 1, 1, 1. Now A plus B plus C I can take common. So 1, 1, 1 here. So 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, similar to identical columns. That means this will be 0. Okay? Next is the most important part, the minus and cofactors. What are minus and cofactors? Because without my minus and cofactors, we cannot do the adjoint. And without doing adjoint, we cannot do the inverses of a matrix and solving a system of equations. Okay? Like linear equations. So, minus, I am telling you, suppose we have a matrix. First of all, what is the notation? Suppose Aij, minor of Aij is Mij. Okay. So, this small Aij means the element of the matrix. And cofactor of Aij is denoted by capital Aij. Okay. So, these notations you have to remember. So suppose you have a matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this is a simple example, 7, 8, 9, 3 by 3 matrix. Suppose what is the minor of 1? Suppose this is actually A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. So minor of A11, that is minor of this 1, will be how to find the minor? The minor will be basically, just like we found the determinant of a 3 by 3 matrix, hide this row and this row and this column, you hide. Okay, so just cut this and this, so you are left with this, basically. So this will be the determinant of this, that is 5, 6, 8, 4. This will be your minor. That means if you just multiply, it will be 20, 5 for the 20, minus 8, 6, yeah, 48. So that will be 20 minus 40, and we don't be calculated. Suppose this 6, if they have asked you. So cut this and this, so that will be 8 into 1, this 8 into 1 minus 7 into 2, that is 8 minus 14. So this is how to find the minor, just hide that, suppose you take an element, hide its corresponding row and column and find the determinant of the remaining 4 elements, for a 3 by 2 matrix. And for a 2 by 2 matrix, suppose you have this 2 by 2 matrix, 1 minus 2, 4, 3. So what is the minor of minus 2? Just hide this, so you are only left with 4, so 4 will be the minor of minus 2. Here see, if you are hiding this column and row, you are left with only one element. So there is no question of finding data elements. So that element itself will be the minor. And what's the problem of cofactor? Aij, that is the capital Aij, that is cofactor, okay? Is minus 1 raised to the power I plus j into minor of ij. Like we already did this, we used this formula to find the element of a 3 by 3 matrix. So suppose minus 2, the minor is, suppose this is 1, 1, 1, 2. So M 1, 2 is 4. But what is A 1, 2? A 1, 2 is, you see, minus 1 to the power I, J. So this is 1, 2. So I plus J. So 1 plus 2 is 3. So minus 1 to the power 3 into this minor, into 4. So that means minus 4. Okay. So that's how you have to do these things, basically. Now, what is the adjoint of a matrix?
This is all about minus and cofactors. Now, what is the adjoint of a matrix? Suppose I have a matrix like this, square matrix A equals Aij, order n cross n, or n cross k, we can write. Now, see, adjoint of A will be, the cofactors. Suppose you have to, first of all, you have to change these elements into their cofactors. So, Aij. And then you have to take the transpose of that. So, understand this very nicely. First of all, you have to change the elements into their cofactors. And then you have to take the transpose of that matrix which you are getting. So, that means you see, one example. Suppose A equals A11, A12, A21, A23. Sorry, A11, A12, A21, A22. So, this is suppose given to you 2, 3, 1, 4. 2, 3, 1, 4. Now, here you have to find the, first of all, you have to find the adjoints. So, adjoint of A11 will be what? Minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1 into A11, that is into 2. That is what? Minus 1 square is just plus 1, so this will be 2. Similarly, A12 will be, this will be odd number, so minus, and minus, the minus, sorry, the minus. So, the minor will be 4 here, okay, 4. Because this is a 2, this, so just cut them and the minor is 4. So, this is plus 4. Similarly, for this, the minor will be this number, that is 1, minus 1. A21 will be, again it's an odd number, so minus, and this number, minus 3. And A22 will be, it's an even number, so plus 2. So, 4, minus 1, minus 3, and plus 2. So the adjoint matrix will be, now, so the resultant matrix which we are getting from changing the elements to their cofactors will be, suppose let's say, yeah, this is our matrix. So this will be, suppose we have A11, that is 4, A12, it's minus 1, A21, minus 3, 2. Now, and A22 is 2. Now, this is not your adjoint of the matrix A. This is only one step. The next step is that you have to take the transpose of this matrix. So we already know how to take the transpose. 4 minus 3, this will become this, and this will become this. Minus 1, 2. So 4 minus 3, minus 1, 2. This is your adjoint of A. This is your adjoint of A. So, it becomes a bit more difficult for a 3x3 matrix, bit more time consuming and everything. But yeah, we have to, like, this is the basic procedure. And once you get the concept, I guess you will be able to deal with that kind of question. So, this is the, how to find the adjoint of A. Now, how this is important to find the inverse of a matrix. So, yesterday we discussed the inverse of a matrix, how to find the inverse of a matrix by using that elementary transformations. That was a bit tedious, but I showed you some patterns. So, if you follow the patterns, then you could do it, right? Now, here you see one thing. Some things you have to remember. Like, what's the, see, A, this is the property. Okay, I think it's a different thing. So, A, oh my gosh. Yeah, A adjoint of A is equal to adjoint of A of A. Now this is actually AB is not equal to BA. If A and B are matrices, then AB equal to BA may not hold. Does not hold. So here suppose, but in this case, A into adjoint of A will be equal to adjoint of A into A. This will be hold true, and this will be equal to determinant of A into I. I is, you know, the identity matrix of the same order. Like if it's a 3x3 matrix, then I will be 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Only the diagonal elements will be 1, identity matrix 1, and rest all non-diagonal elements will be 0. So this formula you have to remember. Now if the determinant of A is 0, if det A is 0, then we call it a singular matrix. If det A is not equal to 0, we call it a non-singular matrix. If det A is 0, then this entire thing will be 0. So in that case we call it a singular matrix. And if det A or the determinant of A is not equal to 0, we call it a non-singular matrix. And one more property you have to remember is that suppose AB whole but in the determinant, that will be equal to determinant of A into determinant of B. This also holds true. Now, a square matrix, see, the inverse of a matrix may exist or may not exist. It's like, it's not necessary that a matrix will always have inverses. So, the inverse of a matrix of a square matrix is invertible if and only if it's non-singular. So, if it's non-singular, only then the inverse exists. And in this case, no inverse or inverse does not exist. So, how to find the inverse? So, what is the definition of inverse? Suppose AB equals BA equals I, then B is called the inverse of A. This we know, this we already know. So suppose we consider this AB equals I. Now we multiply at the, so first of all see, if you take a determinant on both sides, determinant on both sides if you take, that means this will be determinant and determinant B we already discussed here. Now what is the determinant of I? See, determinant of I is C. 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, sorry, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So if you are, suppose we are considering for 3 by 3 matrix only. So if this is, if you take a determinant of this, so these two elements are 0, so just consider for this element. Now for this element 1 into, what is this? 1 into 1 is 1 minus 0. So we are getting 1. So the determinant will be 1. Suppose if you are having a 2 by 2 matrix, 1, 0, 0, 1. Then also the determinant will be 1 into 1 minus 0, that is 1. So if you check it out for identity matrix, the determinant will always be 1. So this is A, determinant A into determinant B equals 1. So this is 1, this is not I, okay, this is 1. So now what we can say is that we have this formula, right? A adjoint, A into adjoint of A equals adjoint A into A equals determinant A, I inverse. So this thing, suppose this determinant of A I want to come in, bring it to the left hand side, to these two terms. Then what will I get? You see very nicely. I will get A into 1 by determinant of A adjoint A is equal to 1 by determinant of A adjoint A into A is equal to I. Right. Now I will compare this equation. A into something equal to something into A equal to I, and this is A into B equals to B into A equals to I. So it's obvious that this something is B. So from here we say that the inverse of matrix A inverse is equal to the adjoint of the matrix divided by the determinant of the matrix. So this is how we can find the inverse of the matrix. So if you know the adjoint and you know the determinant, you can just divide them and you can find the matrix, find the inverse of A. This is a much easier way to find the inverse than doing that those things like elementary operations. So now only a little portion is left. Suppose it's given to you this question as to A is 3, 2, 1, 1, and A square. Suppose it's given that A square plus AA plus BB, sorry, BI equal to 0. Find A and B. So you have to find small a and small b. So first of all, A square, what is A square? A square is A into A, that is multiply them 3, 2, 1, 1 into 3, 2, 1, 1. So that will be, this is, yeah, okay. So that will be 3 into 3 is 9 plus 2 into 1 is 2. Then this will be 3 into 2 is 6. 6 plus 2 into 1 is 2, then this will be 3 into 1 is 3 plus 1 into 1 is 1, then this will be 2 into 1 is 2 plus 1 into 1 is 1. So this will be 11, 8, 4, 2 into 1 is 3. 2 plus 1 is 3. So this is my A square. This is my A square. Now what is AA? So suppose this plus I am doing. So this plus I am doing A into then this matrix 3, 2, 1, 1. Plus I am doing B into I means 1, 0, 0, 1. Identity matrix has the same order. So from here you have to find the value of A and B given that this thing is equal to the null matrix 0, 0, 0, 0. This is O. Okay, so this O means null matrix, 0 matrix. So see, here we have a 11. So this A should be obviously minus because we have to subtract 11 from this, then only we can get a 0. So see, if we actually trial error is also not required. If you just think of it, you will get the answer automatically. A will be minus 4, because you see, if I do minus 4, if I multiply this with minus 4, then I will get here what? 3, 4, 12, minus 12 I will get, and B will be plus 1. So minus 12 plus 1 is minus 11, and 11 minus 11 is 0. Then 8, this is 4 to the 8, and this is 0. So, minus 4 is a minus 8. So, 8 minus 8 is 0. So, these two elements are already 0. Now this is 1, so minus 1 into 1 is 4 and this is 0, so minus 4, 4 minus 4 is 0 and this is 3, this is minus 4 but this is plus 1, so minus 3, 3 minus 3 is 0. So initially we are getting all the elements equal to 0.
Okay? Next is suppose A equals 2, 3, 1, 2. You have to show that A square minus 4A plus I equal to 0 and you have to find the inverse of this matrix A. So A square will be what?
So with this 1, 2, 2 plus 2, 1, 2, 4.
Sorry about that.
So 3, 1, 3 and 2, 2, 4. So 4 plus 3 is 7. So this is what we are getting. Next is 4 into a minus 4a. So 4a means we can directly multiply with 4 this element. So 2 4 is 8, 3 4 is 12, we should multiply with minus 4. But anyway, we should multiply with minus 4. So plus, minus 8, minus 12, then minus 4, minus 8. Plus I. I means what? 1 0 0 1. So obviously see this is 7 plus 1 is 8, 8 minus 8 is 0, so this is 0, then 12 plus minus 12 plus 0, that is 0, 4 minus 4 plus 0, that is 0, 7 plus 1 is 8 minus 8, that is 0. So this is 0, we have already showed that. Now how to find the inverse of the matrix A? So you can find the determinant of A and you can find the, so to find the inverse what you have to do, you have to find the determinant and the adjoint. Inverse is the adjoint divided by the determinant. Or one thing you can also do here, suppose A square, that is AA minus 4A plus I equals 0. This we already know. Okay. So that this is given in the question. Now if I multiply A inverse to each term, so A into A inverse is what? A into A inverse is I. So AI minus 4I plus A inverse equal to 0. So A inverse will be what? 4I minus AI. Now 4I minus AI, see AI, if you multiply any matrix with the identity matrix, then the matrix will not be changed. So AI is just A, you don't need to write this I. But see, 4i, if you don't write the i, then that is just 4 is a number. But 4i is not a number. 4i is 4 multiplied by the identity matrix. So this will be 4, 0, 0, 4. Minus a, minus 2, 3, 1, 2. So this will be 4 minus 2 is 2. 0 minus 3 is minus 3. 0 minus 1 is minus 1. 4 minus 2 is 2. So 2 minus 3 minus 1, 2. So this is your A inverse. Now, you can verify this, you can find the determinant of A, so let's verify this actually, it will be fun. And then we will discuss this linear, the system of equations and then we will be done. So, 2, this is legible I think, yeah. So, 2 minus 3 minus 1, 2, that is A inverse. Now, if you do the initial method, suppose what's the determinant of A? Determinant of A is 2 into 4 minus 3, 1 into 3, that is 1. So, this is not 0, this is non-singular, that means definitely inverse will exist. What is the adjoint of A? Adjoint of A means first of all you see, you have to write the cofactor. So cofactor of 2 is, this is 1, 1. So cofactor of 2 is 2. Then the cofactor of 3 is 1 but minus 1. Then the cofactor of 1 is minus 3. And the cofactor of 2, these 2 will be 2. Right, 2. So this has to change into this transpose of this. So 2 minus 3, minus 1. 2 minus 3, minus 1, 2. So this is adjoint A. Now I have to divide the adjoint A, so adjoint A divided by determinant A. That means this divided by 1. So this only. So see 2 minus 3 minus 1, 2, 2 minus 3 minus 1, 2. So in both the cases we are getting the matrix, the same values, the same answer. The inverse of matrix. So there are many ways to find the inverse of matrix depending on the question. And if it's a 2 by 2 matrix, we can easily find the adjoint actually. Next is, suppose this example, see, this is this requires practice actually, but there are many ways to solve this kind of equation. So I will only show you one example here. Okay. Suppose 2x plus 5y equals 1 and 3x plus 2y equals 7. So here you have to form matrices. Suppose matrix A is these values 2, 5, 3, 2. Matrix X is the variables X and Y. So X and Y. X and Y. And matrix B is these values 1 and 7. Okay? So you see, if I do A into X, what will I get? If I multiply this matrix with this matrix. So 2x plus 5y in the first element. Then I will get what? 2x plus 5y, right? Then 3x plus 2y also I will get. And this is equal to 1, this is equal to 7. So basically I am getting this same system. So I can write that A multiplied by X is equal to B. So this is the matrix representation. Now so AX equals to B if I write, I can find, so from here see, I can find the solution. I need to find this X and Y, right? I need to find B. So X will be B into A inverse, right? A I am taking this side, so A inverse. That means this will be B, we already know what is B, B is 1, 7. And what is A inverse? A inverse is what, the determinant of A? Determinant of A will be 2 to the 4 minus 5 to the 15, so that is minus 11. So minus 1 by 11, or we should not write like this. First of all, minus 1 by 11 or 1 by minus 11, because it's 1 by the determinant, then adjoint of A, then into this matrix, 1 into this B. So AX is B, so X is simply B into A inverse. Now what's the adjoint of A? So this is 2, so this cofactor will also be 2. This is 5, cofactor will be minus 3. This is cofactor will be minus 5, and this is cofactor will be 2. Now we have to just do something. So this will be 2 minus 5, let's just take a transpose. And minus 3, 2. So 1 by minus 1 by 11, 2 minus 5, minus 3, 2. So now we multiply these two matrices. Minus 1 by 11, see 2 into 1 is 2, minus 5 into 7 is, that is, see, minus 5 into 7, that is minus 35. So minus 35 plus, so that is minus 33. Okay. Next we have minus 3 into 1 is minus 3, 7 into 14, so 14 minus 3 is 11. So 1 by 11 minus 1 by 11 have to multiply. So if you multiply minus 1 by 11 with minus 33, that is 33 by 11, that is 3. And minus 1 by 11 with 11, that is minus 1. So this was our, originally this was our X and Y, this matrix, X and Y. So X is, so from here we can say X is 3 and Y is minus 1. So you can try solving the equation in any other way, you can also give you the same answer. So, in this way, once you get a bit of practice, you can easily solve these kind of equations using the matrix algebra. So, that is all of our today's video. So, I hope you enjoyed the video and I hope it was helpful. So, and I would ask you to check out the matrices video also if you're here. So, that's all for this video. Thank you very much.